صلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. So we're going to have a little interaction this morning about Surah Al-Fatiha. So I'm going to ask questions, inshallah, and then we go around and benefit, inshallah. So the first question, can anyone give me some of the names of Surah Al-Fatiha? The names of Surah Al-Fatiha. The mother of the Quran. Ahsant. So it is called the mother of the Quran. Can anyone, like, seems like you're awake, mister, this morning. You look good, huh? The mother of the Quran, why would it be called the mother of the Quran? The mother of the Quran. Just look at the word. The mother of the Quran.
It summarizes.
Like you have a state, right? And you have a capital of that state. Mm-hmm. Right? The mother of the Quran. What does it mean? It has the foundations of the Quran. Ahsan. Now we're talking. Okay. Any other name, Ismail? Come on, Ismail.
I don't remember. The beginning.
It is the opening chapter of the Quran. Fatihat al-Kitab. Mm-hmm. The opening chapter of the Quran. Any other names? Alhamd. Ahsant. Alhamd, because it starts with Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. So the ulama, the scholars, they call it Alhamd. Because it starts with it. And I'm going to help you. Inshallah, but don't forget, because I'm going to ask you again. Don't forget. Okay. It is also called a Shafi. Shafi means what? The healer. The healer. The cure. The remedy. Why? Because of the hadith that is in Sahih al-Bukhari. Right? The hadith of Abu Sa'id Al-Khudri, radiallahu anhu. When the Sahaba, they were traveling, and they came to this village, they asked the people to take them as guests. And you know, back then, the people, they were very generous, you know, until today, they're very generous. So the people, they refused to take them as guests. So the leader of the tribe, he got stung by a scorpion. And they could not help him. They tried everything, but nothing worked. So they said to themselves, why don't we go and ask those people that came to us as guests, and we rejected them. Maybe they have something. And so they went, and they told them, we will not cure him by the will of Allah unless you give us a flock of sheep. So they said, okay, we will do that. So Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, radiallahu an, he started reciting Surah al-Fatiha on this man. Look at the power of the Qur'an. You're talking about the Qur'an versus what? Poison. SubhanAllah. He recited Surah al-Fatiha on him. And the narration, it says, كَأَنَّهُ نَشِطَ مِنْ عِقَامِ. It's like a camel that was tied up, and you untie that camel. What is he going to do? He's going to spring into action, right? SubhanAllah. Look, the cure, the Quran. Allah, Allah. And I was reading the statement of Imam Ibn Qayyim, rahimahullah. It's a great scholar. His ibadah was amazing, this scholar, rahimahullah. When he used to make tawaf, the people, they will stop just to watch him making tawaf, subhanAllah. His ibadah was amazing, rahimahullah ta'ala. So Ibn al-Qayyim, he said when he was in Mecca, he used to get sick. And he said, I could not find any remedies for it except the Quran. He said, I would take water and I will recite in it and I will drink it. SubhanAllah. Or I will just recite my palm like this, blow and wipe. He said, everything goes away. Allahu Akbar. Quran. Adamat al-Quran, the greatness of the Quran. It's the speech of Allah, Kalam Allah, the speech of Allah. Any other names of Surah Al-Fatiha? It is also called Ar-Rukn, the pillar. The pillar, why? because one hadith. Well, what's the hadith? Can anybody mention this hadith? That's why they call it al-rukn, the pillar, because of one hadith. There are other hadith, but this is the main hadith.
Without Surah Fatiha?
Yes.
The salat is not valid.
Yes, it's a hadith collected by Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim on the authority of Ubad al-Mustafa, radiallahu anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لا صلاة لمن لم يقرأ بفاتحة الكتاب. There is no prayer for the one who does not recite the opening chapter of the book, the Quran. So basically, we can give you some scenarios, right? Fiqh scenarios. If someone forgot to recite Surah Al-Fatiha, for example, in the first rak'ah, right? And then he went all the way down to sujood, and then he remembered. He has to go back up, recite Surah Al-Fatiha, then make ruku' again, sujood, and all that. And then at the end of the salat, he makes two sajda of forgetfulness before he salams out. So this is the first scenario. Second scenario. He did not remember until he was in the second rak'ah. The first rak'ah is null void. Gone. Second rak'ah becomes the first. And at the end of the salat, he makes two sajda of forgetfulness before he salams out. Third scenario. He does not remember until he salams out. In that case, he makes up the whole rak'ah. You see how important Surah Al-Fatiha is? He would make up the whole rak'ah. You see? So these are the names of Surah Al-Fatiha. Now, can anybody tell me, Surah Al-Fatiha we know is the greatest surah in the Quran. But what is the dalil? What is the proof? Anybody from the Quran? Give me one ayah from the Quran. Give me a hadith of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why Surah Al-Fatiha is the greatest surah of the Quran? Okay, I'm gonna give you the surah, but you have to find the ayah. It's very very easy. Surah Al-Hijr. Surah Al-Hijr. Just give me the ayah. That's it. Surah Al-Hijr. Surah Al-Hijr. Anybody remember? Okay. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِ وَالْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ. We have given you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the seven often repeated verses. What is it, seven often repeated verses? Al-Fatiha. Because it has seven ayats. وَالْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ and the glorious Qur'an. So look, the superiority of Surah Al-Fatiha. Allah mentioned it first. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِ. And we have given you the seven often repeated verses. He started with it first. And then the Quran, العظيم, shows you how important. Like, for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًا لِلَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَجِبْرِيلَ وَمِيكَالِ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَدُوٌ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. Right? So Allah said, whoever is an enemy to Allah and His angels. Okay, angels. Is it general or specific? General. No, general. All the angels. All the angels. Malaikatihi, all the angels. And then after that he said, وَجِبْرِيلَ وَمِيكَالِ. And Jibreel and Mikal. Why would Allah mention Jibreel and Mikal after He mentioned all the angels? Why? Because they have a special status. Special status. They are the best of the angels. Jibreel wa Mikal. So Allah mentioned them. Like when you mention, you say, the Al-Anbiya wa Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he's the leader of all the Prophet and messengers sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it shows you, Ikhwan, that Surah Al-Fatiha is extremely, extremely important. So the dalil, the proof from the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ is the hadith that is in Sahih Bukhari, hadith of Abu Sa'id ibn al-Mu'alla. So I will translate, I will avoid the Arabic, I will translate straight. So the Abu Sa'id ibn al-Mu'alla, he was praying. And the Prophet ﷺ called him. And he did not respond because he was in the prayer. So when he finished, he told them, why didn't you respond to me? He said, O Messenger of Allah, I was in the Salat. He said, Allah said in the Quran, يا أيها الذين آمنوا استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم. He told him, the Prophet ﷺ, he told him, Allah said in the Quran, O you who believe, respond to Allah and His Messenger. When He calls you to that gives you that which gives you life. Allahu Akbar. Allah. So he should have responded, but he did not because he thought he could not because he was in the Salah. So then he told him, shall I teach you the greatest surah in the Quran before you leave the masjid? He said, when he was leaving, he took my hand. And we were coming out of the masjid. So I said to him, O Messenger of Allah, you told me you're going to teach me the greatest surah in the Quran. In the Prophet ﷺ, he said, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, هي السبع المثاني والقرآن العظيم الذي أوتيته. He said, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, praise be to Allah. هي السبع المثاني. It is the seven often repeated verses in the Quran and the glorious Quran that was I received from Allah, that I was given. So he shows you here in this hadith as well as Surah Al-Hijr that Surah Al-Fatiha is the greatest surah in the whole Quran. So inshallah, we will stop here and then tomorrow inshallah we'll continue. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all the beneficial knowledge and righteous action. May Allah unite us with our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in al-firdaws al-a'la ma'a an-nabiyyin was-siddiqin wash-shuhada was-salihin wa hasuna ulaika rafiqa walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Barakallahu fikum.